This plane's flown out of Boeing Field for months, a Boeing 737 MAX 9 with a special paint job. King 5 was on board Sunday, heading down to San Francisco International. You would think this was just another flight in a 737, but inside, it's a highly computerized flying laboratory.
This is a plane that will fly for Alaska Airlines that right now is being used to test environmental technologies.
We've got sustainable aviation fuels that were in the emissions, working with NASA.
Doug Christensen is the chief architect for Boeing's Eco Demonstrator program.
So these are the sensors that we're working on with NOAA.
In many cases, Boeing's working with other organizations. NOAA is the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. The National Weather Service is part of NOAA, but the agency also has multiple research arms.
We're looking at two different units. We've got sample test units that are taking that air. They're looking at the composition of the greenhouse gases.
Gases, including carbon dioxide and methane, the readings displayed on this computer monitor.
They're looking at the profile of those greenhouse gases, you know, from the ground up into the atmosphere.
Commercial aircraft represent a really great platform for sampling the atmosphere.
I reach Colm Sweeney in Boulder, Colorado. He's the associate director of NOAA's Global Monitoring Laboratory. If this technology does the job, it could be put onto thousands of airliners to better track greenhouse gases.
What the aircraft profiles allow us to do is to really quantify the total impact to the atmosphere.
The fuel on our flight is a 50-50 blend of regular jet fuel and what's now being called SAF, or sustainable aviation fuel. SAF is made from plants, waste animal products, and even refined from trash. The problem is making enough of it.
I feel a much greater sense of urgency and momentum than in the last couple of years.
Diana Burkett Rocco is Alaska Airlines Senior VP for Public Affairs and Sustainability.
As there is sufficient demand for SAF, I think that there could potentially be more interesting technology, investor interest in producing SAF.
Carbon emissions can be cut in other ways, flying more directly, reducing drag and weight. Outside this plane, Boeing's testing low-profile anti-collision lighting. It takes more fuel to push an older, bigger light like this through the air.
What went away?
So on our aisle stand here, which is...
Then there's inside the cockpit. Kerry Smith is our pilot. Boeing is testing to see if more buttons and knobs for radios and other devices can be put onto a touchscreen.
But all of the tuning panels are gone, saving us weight, and every little bit helps.
The pandemic hit Boeing hard as passengers stopped flying and airlines struggled. Boeing cut jobs and its balance sheet turned red. But research continued. Ray Lutters heads the Eco Demonstrator program.
Sustainable aviation doesn't stop because of a pandemic. We still have to do our part to accelerate technologies, and that takes some time. So we continued moving forward, planning a flight test program during a global pandemic, all virtually. And we had such success that we're able to continue that and continue moving forward with a larger program like we have with Alaska Airlines.
So the Eco Demonstrator program is over 10 years old now, and about a third of the technologies tested have actually made it onto airliners. Another third worthy of further study. At 35,000 feet, Glenn Farley, King 5.